What's up, my video editing PD peeps? Today, I'm gonna show you how to edit on a smartphone like a pro using the PowerDirector Video Editor app. If you're new to my channel and you wanna learn how to use PowerDirector, click the subscribe button and click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. A firm understanding of basic editing and how the PowerDirector app works will help you edit a professional video for your next project. When you access the app, you're presented with the main screen. It has several options below that we can touch on in future videos, but today we're going to edit a video on our smartphone. So what you need to do is click on New Project. So you want to go ahead and give your project a name. And then you want to pick a aspect ratio. So if you're doing something like on Facebook or Instagram, you might do a 1:1 or a 4:5. If you're doing something else where you wanted to show on a smartphone, then you might do 9:16. For this, we're going to do 16:9. So we'll tap on that. And then you're presented with the screen to import assets. If you got videos that you want to do, you want to make sure that you're on the video tab. Then go to the location on your device where the videos are. And then you want to tap on a video that you want to use. Tap the plus sign and it'll add it to the timeline. Now, if you want your next video that you add to be before it, you should leave your playhead there. But if you want your next video to be added after it, move your playhead behind that video. Tap on the next video that you want to use and then tap on the plus sign and it'll add it behind it. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to add some music. So I'm going to move my playhead back to the beginning and we're going to tap on music. And then we'll go to the location where the music is that we want to use, tap on the plus sign, and it'll add it to the timeline as well. Now, if you want to add any images or pictures, then all you need to do is go ahead and tap on photo, go to the location for that, and add your photos as well. So we're going to tap on back, and it'll send us back to the main screen. Now, if you want to see your videos, you can go ahead and place your finger on the video timeline and move it to scrub the videos. This will help you be able to see what's going to play on the timeline. If you just want to play it in real time, you just go ahead and tap on the play button and it'll play the video for you in real time. Let's say your clips are not in the order that you want them to be in. Well, you can move your clips around. All you got to do is hold your finger over a clip until you see that yellow bounding box, and then you can drag it over to where you want it to go and let it go, and you can move your clips around like that. Next thing that we want to do is trim these clips. So usually when you record any video, you may want to remove the front, the rear, or a middle section of a clip. If you need to see more frames on your timeline to know exactly where you're changing or editing or trimming your video, you can go ahead and place two fingers on the timeline and pinch it out so that you can see more frames of your video. If you go in, you're going to see less frames and you'll see each clip closer together. So to trim a clip and to remove some of it, you want to tap on a clip and then you place your finger at the end where you see the little dash on the white line. And you can go ahead and tell that you're trimming it by looking at where that blue and the white go. You can trim the end as well by placing your finger on the end and trimming some off the end of the video. But let's say you wanted to trim something in the middle. You can place your playhead where you want. You can tap on the split button. And now we can trim things in the middle. Also, let's say there was a section that you wanted to remove in the middle and you wanted to take it out of there. You can actually add another split by tapping on the clip, tapping on split, and then we've created this little section in the middle, and we can delete that by just tapping on the trash bin. And if you make a mistake while you're editing, you could tap on the undo button and you can go ahead and move right back. You can undo as many times as you want and get it right back to the original size video. Now you can see that when you tap on a clip, there's all these options that show up at the bottom of the screen. So most of these options are self-explanatory, like speed will change the speed, skin smoother will smooth the skin, pan and zoom, all that stuff. One of the things that you're probably going to use a lot is crop. So if you tap on crop, it brings up a full size of the image. And when it brings this up, you can go ahead and crop out or crop in a different section. So if you want to zoom in, you can crop in like that. And once you're done, you can just tap back. It'll send you back to the timeline and you can see that now that clip is zoomed in. So now I'm going to trim the rest of my clips so that the duration of the clips is the same duration as the music. Now that the videos are all trimmed, we can apply color correction and any effects that we want to add. So let's go ahead and tap on this car. And we're going to go ahead and tap on adjustments. And then we're going to go ahead and tap on temperature. So temperature, you can change the color temperature. You can make it warmer or cooler. I guess we can mess with this, make it a little bit cooler. And then also, if we wanted to, we can tap on saturation. And we can bring the saturation up a little bit on this. Let's make that red pop a little bit. Get a little popping with some freshness and the redness. And then if we wanted to, we can add an effect. Let's go ahead and let's tap on the other clip and let's tap on effects. And here, let's go and we'll tap on dreamy. And if you tap on this little adjustment here, some of these effects let you change the different degrees or the amount of the effect. If you want to, we could bring it up or down. I'm going to leave it where it was at 5. It's all good in the hood. And then you can tap on back. And if you want to, you can tap on back again. You can also add filters. And let's go ahead and tap on this clip here. And if we tap on filter, there's a lot of different filters which add different types of effects to the videos. So you could tap on them. You could change the degree of the filter if you want to bring it up or down. So let's go ahead and leave that there. It looks pretty good. So you got all those options. There's a lot of different things down here that you can play with and learn about. Like I said before, most of them are self-explanatory. So now that we got the color correction and the effects completed, we can go ahead and add a title. And also, you can add other types of overlays like videos or pictures, whatever you want to use. So if you want to add an overlay, you can tap on the overlay icon. And then you can add videos and you can put videos over them like a picture in picture. Or if you're doing green screen, you can use it for that. You can add photos. So if you have like a transparency of your logo or something and you want to add your logo, you can overlay your logo over things. Today, we're just going to go ahead and use a title. So we're going to overlay a title and we're going to go ahead and place it over here at the end. So I want to tap on this clip to make sure that the playhead goes right to the beginning of this clip. And then I'm going to go ahead and tap on the overlay icon again. And I'm going to stay under the title tab. And let's go ahead and pick a minimalist title. So let's tap on minimalist. And we'll tap on this title here. We'll tap on the plus sign, which will add it right where the playhead is at the beginning of that clip. So if you tap on the title that you added, you can go ahead and make adjustments to it. Right now, you can tell that it's at add your title. So if I tap on edit, I can change these words. And tap on the little check mark. And it added the word that I had there. Now I can change the font. So if I want something different, go here and I can change that. And you can also change the color if you want to. And then when you're ready to change the other font, you can just, or the other words, you can just tap on the arrow, pick the words, then edit it. And once you have your text set up, you can go ahead and rotate it if you want to. Just hold your finger over the rotate option and you can turn it. Or you can leave it like that. You can resize it. You can make it bigger, smaller. You can drag it to a position on the screen where you want it. And once you got it all set up, you can go ahead and trim your title. So we want to make sure that the title is the same duration as the clip that it's showing over. So we just place our finger here and trim it back. And now it should only show up on the screen for the same duration of time as the image. So now that we're done with that, you can go ahead and add some transitions between these scenes if you want to. Like some people use jump cuts. So if you just play it, it might just jump to the next scene. But if you want to have transitions, you want to have a smooth transition, then you need to apply transitions in between these clips. So to do that, you need to tap on this little icon that's in between the clips. And then you get some options here for some transitions. You see there's a bunch of different transitions to choose from. I'm going to tap on split. And I'm going to tap on split 4. And as you see, it applies a transition there. And it gives you a quick preview of what it's going to look like. Now, based on the transition you use, if you pick like a basic transition and you pick a fade, then you have a duration slider. So you can change how long the duration of the transition is based on what type of transition you select. For this, I'm just going to use these split transitions. Once you're done with your effects, your color correction, and your transitions, and all the other stuff, trimming, cutting, all of that beautifulness, then what you want to do is you want to edit your audio. So we'll tap on the music, and you get some options down here. So the first one is to duplicate your music. So let's say you have more clips than the music, and you wanted to duplicate the music, split it, and keep it going. Then all you really have to do is tap on this duplicate, and it'll add the same music behind it. You'll have to trim it down in order to make it all sync up with the music so that it seems like it's longer. I'm gonna go ahead and delete this because I'm not gonna use that. Let's tap on the music again. And the next option that we have on here is the audio tool. So if you tap on that, you get a voice changer and denoise. So if you have a lot of noise in your video, you can tap on the denoiser and use the slider here to determine how much of the effect you want to add or apply, just to go ahead and remove that denoise on there. Then you also have your audio mixing. So audio mixing allows you to change the volume of different tracks so that you hear one audio track over another. So if you wanted to hear, let's say someone speaking louder than the music, then you can adjust that track right here in the audio mixer. So then you also have your volume. So for any clip that you tap on or any audio, whatever, if you tap on it and it has audio, then you'll get this option to go ahead and mute that audio. Or you can go ahead and fade it in at the beginning or fade it out at the end. Now that you're done with all of your audio and your assets and your video is all put together and is beautiful, you want to produce your video so that you can share it online or play it on your device. So to do that, you need to tap on this produce icon. You have several options here. You can share it on Facebook, YouTube. You have some other options, or you can send it to the CyberLink cloud. Now we're going to go ahead and save it on our device. So we're going to go ahead and choose save to gallery or SD card. So we'll tap on that. You also have some options here. You can do ultra HD or 4K. You can do full HD, standard HD, or standard definition. You also have settings. So if you tap on settings, you can change the save location. Just tap on it. You can choose a different location. You can change your bitrate. So your bitrate is the quality of your video. Higher bitrates have higher quality, but if you have a smaller size and a lower bitrate, the quality is going to be lower as well. So if you're okay with the amount of storage you have, use better quality because your video will look better. Then you also have your frame rate. So you have 24 frames per second, and then you have 25 for if you're over in Europe and some other PAL locations. You got 30 frames per second, 50 frames per second, or 60 frames per second. So you got all of those options. Once you have all your settings, you just go ahead and tap on produce, and it will go ahead and produce the video on your device. Professional video on a smartphone. Ain't that a novel idea? If you like what you see, I'll leave a link to try out the PowerDirector app in the video description. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.